Recently, a CNN reporter had the opportunity to talk to a Trump supporter outside of an event where he asked the Trump supporter, "You've been watching what's happening with these committee hearings?" And as soon as the Trump supporter opened her mouth, things immediately went off the rails as she spouted conspiracy theories while also contradicting herself in a very important way. So without giving too much away, here is the clip. Take a look.
This rally, a bonfire of conspiracy theories.
Have you watched the January 6th hearings?
I have.
What do you think?
I think they're a bunch of bullshit.
Why?
Well, because do you have both sides, or are you getting one side of the story?
You mean like the side that attacked the Capitol?
You really believe that happened?
I was there.
Okay. I have a lot of people that were there too.
And?
And saw things that it wasn't what they say it was.
But there's been hundreds of Trump supporters now charged. A lot of them have pled guilty.
And do you think it's right for those people to have those people in jail and not get any justice in our American system? Are you kidding me?
Do you think it was right that they attacked the Capitol?
I don't, they didn't. That was an inside job, buddy.
Okay. All right. Give it a minute here. So first and foremost, of course, the committee's not reporting both sides, right? Like the woman says, they're not giving us both sides of the Capitol riot. Like, what both sides are there? You want to hear from the actual Capitol rioters? Then why don't you go read the court transcripts of these people whining and crying like little babies, expressing their sorrow for what happened, and in a lot of instances, actually blaming your guy, Donald Trump, for baiting them into doing it. They're not going into court blaming Antifa. They're going into court blaming Donald Trump, you idiot. If you paid attention to anything other than conservative media, you would know that. And then, of course, she says, well, my friends were there. I know people who were there. I know people who were there. And then she goes, say, nope, this was an inside job. So you know personally human beings that participated in the Capitol riot and then in the same breath have the audacity to say it was an inside job. So the question I have for this lunatic is, do the people you know that were there, do they work for the government? Were they FBI agents? Were they the instigators? Like, how can you say you know people that participated in the riot and then turn around and say the whole thing was an inside job? Like, I think that deserves a little bit of a broader explanation, right? You can't claim something is an inside job of the government and then also claim that, yeah, a lot of my good buddies were there too. That makes absolutely no sense. That is a complete contradiction. But this clip, in addition to being hilariously stupid, shows us the level of just complete abandonment of reality that we are dealing with regard to these Trump supporters. It doesn't matter what facts you put in front of them. It doesn't matter how many times you debunk something. They will not listen. You can put it in their face and they don't care. They're gonna tell you you're wrong. They're gonna give you a conspiracy theory to explain why you're wrong. They're gonna make stuff up. They're gonna deny it. They're gonna pretend like everything they believe is the absolute truth and only people who have opened their eyes can see it. This is lunacy that we are dealing with. These are not rational people. These aren't individuals that you can pull aside and be like, hey, let's have a real rational talk. Let's have a debate. You can't do that with these people. They are lost. The only people who might be able to do that are mental health professionals, which I'm assuming you're not a mental health professional. Some of you might be. Okay, you might be able to reach these people, but I know I couldn't. Nobody else who does what I do could. The corporate media can't. Politicians can't. These people are gone. They are suffering, I believe firmly, from a form of psychosis that requires professional help. Because when you're presented with reality and you refuse to accept it, you choose instead to live in your alternate fantasy world, that's a symptom. That's not a political movement. That's not an ideology. It's a symptom of severe problems.
This is Hattie. Hattie wants to know why you have not subscribed to our channel. You obviously like our videos, so do us a favor and subscribe.